Hello students, I am Mrs. Kavita Upadhyay, your English teacher. I welcome all the students of class 9 to today's English class. Today students, we are going to read the second chapter of your book Beehive. This is your prose and poetry book. We are going to read the lesson 2, The Sound of Music. We will cover this lesson in two parts and this is part 1 of the lesson. The subheading given to part 1 of the lesson is Evelyn Glennie listens to sound without hearing it. This is the story of Evelyn Glennie, and they say that she listens to sound without hearing it, and it is very interesting to find out how someone can listen without hearing. Objectives of today's lesson are to expose you to the life of a great musician, Evelyn Glennie, to inspire and motivate you by showing you that nothing is impossible for a determined mind. What is a determined mind? When you are resolute, when you decide something and you stick to it. To promote love for reading and writing, to develop your language ability. Introduction. My question to you is, how many sense organs do we have? You know that we have sense organs to feel what is going on around. And how many sense organs do we have? 5. I know you all know. These are eyes, tongue, ears, nose and skin. We see, taste, hear, smell and touch with these sense organs. And that is how we gather information about what is going on around. Think you can learn music if you can't hear? Do you think that we can learn music if we cannot hear? It is quite impossible. Why? Because unless and until you listen to different notes and identify them, you cannot express yourself musically. This is a story of Evelyn Glennie, who can play more than 1,000 instruments. That is why she is called a multi-percussionist. She is deaf, but she can feel the sound with the help of vibrations. Now students, we are going to read the story of Evelyn Glennie. This is a biography. Biography means the story of someone's life. This is the story of the life of Evelyn Glennie. And who is Evelyn Glennie? Who can play more than 1,000 instruments? She can play more than 1,000 musical instruments, and that is why she is called a multi-percussionist. Percussionist is a person who can play musical instruments, especially the musical instruments which can be played by striking one object against the other. Percussion instruments are the instruments in which the music is played by striking one thing against the other. And she plays more than 1,000 percussion instruments. She is deaf, but she can feel the sound. She cannot hear with her ears, but she can feel the sound. How? With the help of vibrations. Now, before we read this biography, we should know about the author. The author of this story of Evelyn Glennie is Deborah Cowley. She grew in the city of Toronto in Canada. She is an Ottawa-based writer and broadcaster. She has written many books and stories. She is the author of Cairo, A Practical Guide, and she is the co-author of One Woman's Journey, A Portrait of Pauline Vanier. Now, let us read the story. Rush hour crowds jostle for position on the underground train platform. A slight girl, looking younger than her 17 years, was nervous yet excited as she felt the vibrations of the approaching train. Now, what is rush hour? When you are rushing from one place to another, this is called rush hour. Rush hour is the hour of day when most people are going to their work or to their schools or colleges. This is called rush hour. There is crowd on the roads and even on the underground platform. And people jostle for position because they have to board the train. They want to get the position so that it becomes easy for them to board the train. And they jostle for it. Jostle means pushing roughly. They push each other roughly to get position. A slight girl looking younger than her 17 years. A girl who was 17 years, but she looked younger. That means what kind of structure she has. She did not look 17. It was slight. Slight means she must be short and she must be thin. Was nervous yet excited. She was nervous as well as excited. These are two opposite feelings. Why she has those opposite feelings, we will find out when we read the next part. As she felt the vibrations of the approaching train. She felt the vibrations of the train approaching. Approaching means coming close to the railway platform. She could not hear the sound of the train coming. She could feel the vibrations. And as she felt the vibrations, she felt nervous as well as excited. It was her first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London, and daunting enough for any teenager fresh from a Scottish farm. But this aspiring musician faced a bigger challenge than most. She was profoundly deaf. Why was she excited? She was excited because it was her first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London. She was excited to go to this place because this was a prestigious place. Prestigious Royal Academy of Music. And where was it situated? It was situated in London. So she was excited because it was her first day. And daunting enough for any teenager fresh from a Scottish farm. Where was she coming from? She was coming from Scottish farm. That means a small place in Scotland. She was coming from a small place in Scotland and she was just a teenager. She was 17. You remember that? So going to such prestigious place, what kind of experience should it be? It should frighten her a bit. That is why she was nervous, because it was frightening for any teenager to go to such a prestigious place. And more so because she was coming from a small place and she was going to a very prestigious academy of music that was situated in a very big city, London. But this aspiring musician faced a bigger challenge than most. She was an aspiring musician. Aspiring means when you have something as your aim. It was her aim to become a musician. She faced a bigger challenge than most of the teenagers going to the Royal Academy of Music in London for the first time because she was profoundly deaf. She could not hear at all. Now you have to tell whether these statements are true or false. First is, Evelyn was excited because she was going to board a train for the first time. Is it true or false? Yes, it is false. Why? Because she was excited as she was going for the first time to the Royal Academy of Music in London. She could not hear at all. This is the second statement. Is it true? Yes, it is true. She could not hear at all. She was profoundly deaf. She came from Scotland. Is it true? Yes, she came from Scottish farm. She was going to the Royal Academy of Music, Scotland. Is it true? Think. Read it carefully. She was going to the Royal Academy of Music, Scotland. Yes, it is false. Because she was going to the Royal Academy of Music, but it was situated not in Scotland, but in London. Now the second paragraph is, Evelyn Glennie's loss of hearing had been gradual. Her mother remembers noticing something was wrong when the 8-year-old Evelyn was waiting to play the piano. Evelyn Glennie's loss of hearing had been gradual. Gradual means not sudden. Something that is not sudden is gradual. Gradual means slow, step by step. Her mother remembers noticing something was wrong when the 8-year-old Evelyn was waiting to play the piano. She was waiting for her turn to play the piano. What was her age at that time? She was 8-year-old. And at that time, her mother noticed that something was wrong. What was wrong? They called her name and she didn't move. I suddenly realized she hadn't heard, says Isabel Glennie. For quite a while, Evelyn managed to conceal her growing deafness from friends and teachers. Evelyn Glennie's mother's name is Isabel Glennie. She says they called her name. Her name was announced and she didn't move. But she didn't move to the stage to perform. She kept sitting. Her mother felt that she hadn't heard her name being announced. For quite a while, Evelyn managed to conceal her growing deafness from friends and teachers. Conceal means, like, this is my hand. I put another hand. My hand is there, but it is hidden. So the deafness was there, but it was hidden. This is concealing. So she managed to conceal her growing deafness. Her deafness was growing gradually, but she managed to hide it from friends and teachers. They did not come to know that she was becoming more and more deaf gradually. But by the time she was 11, her marks deteriorated and her headmistress urged her parents to take her to a specialist. It was then discovered that her hearing was severely impaired as a result of gradual nerve damage. But by the time she was 11, her marks deteriorated. This is deteriorated, means going down, down, down. So her marks at school fell so low that her headmistress had to press her parents to take her to a specialist, an expert. It was then discovered, something is there, but it is covered. But when you remove that cover, you discover it. So the deafness was there, but it was covered. Now it was discovered, it was found that her hearing was severely impaired. It was severely weakened. It was weakened to a great extent as a result of gradual nerve damage. Gradually means slowly. Her nerve which was responsible for taking the sense of hearing to brain from ear, was getting damaged, and that is why she was not able to hear. They were advised that she should be fitted with hearing aids and sent to a school for the deaf. Everything suddenly looked black, says Evelyn. They were advised by whom? By whom? By the specialist, that she should be fitted with hearing aids. Hearing aids is a device which helps the deaf people listen, hear with their ear. So she should be given hearing aids so that she may hear something, and sent to the school for the deaf. And also that she should be sent to the school for the deaf because she had special needs now. Everything suddenly looked black, says Evelyn. The life was going on normally till now, but suddenly there was this change, drastic change, and everything looked black. She didn't know what would happen next. Now, you have to pick the correct options. Evelyn lost her sense of hearing at the age of 8 or 11. What is the correct answer? Evelyn lost her sense of hearing at the age of 8 or 11. Right answer is 11. Her deafness was first noticed. That means she had some difficulty in hearing, was first noticed by her mother at the age of 8. But her deafness was confirmed at the age of 11. Her deafness was confirmed by her mother or the specialist. Who confirmed it? Her deafness was confirmed by the specialist at the age of 11 when she was taken to the specialist or an expert at the advice of her headmistress. But Evelyn was not going to give up. She was determined to lead a normal life and pursue her interest in music. One day she noticed a girl playing a xylophone and decided that she wanted to play it too. But Evelyn was not going to give up. Give up means give up, surrender. She was not going to surrender to the circumstances. She was determined to lead a normal life. She had decided that she would lead a normal life and she was going to stick to her resolution and pursue her interest in music. She also wanted that she would follow her interest in the field of music. One day she noticed a girl playing a xylophone. One day she saw a girl who was playing xylophone and she decided to play it too, that she also wanted to play xylophone. This is a xylophone which has wooden bars of different length and it is played with the help of sticks having rubber tip. Most of the teachers discouraged her, but percussionist Ron Forbes spotted her potential. He began by tuning two large drums to different notes. Most of the teachers discouraged her. Discouraged her means told her that you will not be able to do it. You will not be able to play xylophone and pursue interest in music. But percussionist Ron Forbes, but there was a percussionist, you know, one who plays percussion instruments. His name was Ron Forbes. He spotted her potential. Spotted her potential. Spotted means realized that she has some ability. And he tried to train her. And to begin with, he took two large drums and adjusted them to the pitch of different notes. You know that music has seven notes. There are seven notes of music. Sa re ga ma pa dha ni, or in English, do re mi fa sol la ti. So he adjusted the two drums to different notes of music. Now you can see Ron Forbes with Evelyn Glennie in this picture. He is the person who made Evelyn Glennie who she is. Don't listen through your ears, he would say. Try to sense it some other way, says Evelyn. Suddenly I realized I could feel the higher drum from the waist up and the lower one from the waist down. Don't listen through your ears, he would say. Who is he? He would say, who is he? He is Ron Forbes. He would say, don't listen through your ears. Why? Why not through your ears? Because he knew that Evelyn would not be able to hear through her ears even if she tried to. He advised her, try to sense it some other way. That she should try to sense music in some other way, other than hearing through her ear. Says Evelyn, suddenly I realized I could feel the higher drum from waist up and the lower one from the waist down. Suddenly, Evelyn also felt that she could feel the notes coming from the higher drum in the parts of her body above her waist and the notes coming from the lower drum in the parts of her body below waist. Forbes repeated the exercise and soon Evelyn discovered that she could sense certain notes in different parts of her body. I had learned to open my mind and body to sounds and vibrations. The rest was sheer determination and hard work. Forbes repeated the exercise. That means he started giving her practice. And soon Evelyn discovered means found, I told you that she could sense certain notes in different parts of her body. That she could sense different notes in different parts of her body. This is how she started identifying different notes. I had learned to open my mind and body to sounds and vibrations. With the help of Ron Forbes, she had found a way to feel music. And this was opening the mind and body to the vibrations that came from the sound of different notes. The rest was sheer determination and hard work. And what was left to succeed, to become a musician, was only determination and hard work. And this she put in plenty. Say whether these statements are true or false. Evelyn Glennie was deaf by birth. Do you think this is correct? It is false. Evelyn Glennie lost her sense of hearing gradually. Second is, most of her teachers discouraged her when she wanted to play xylophone. Is it true? Yes, it is true. Most of her teachers discouraged her because they thought that if she cannot hear, she cannot identify different notes of music, and then she cannot play music. Evelyn was a girl with firm determination. Is it true? Was she a girl with firm determination? Yes, it is true. Because what was needed for her to succeed was sheer determination and hard work. She never looked back from that point onwards. She toured the United Kingdom with a youth orchestra, and by the time she was 16, she had decided to make music her life. She never looked back from that point onwards. Once she started identifying different notes and she got practice, and Ron Forbes started helping her learn music, she never looked back from that point onwards. Never looked back means marched on and on the way to success. She toured the United Kingdom with a youth orchestra. Now, orchestra is a performance given by group of performers playing different instruments. So she joined a youth orchestra and toured the United Kingdom. Toured the United Kingdom means gave performances in the different parts of the United Kingdom. And by the time she was 16, she had decided to make music her life. She auditioned for the Royal Academy of Music and scored one of the highest marks in the history of the Academy. She gradually moved from the orchestral work to solo performances. At the end of her 3-year course, she had captured most of the top awards. Now, she auditioned for the Royal Academy of Music. Now, in the beginning, you know that she was going to the Royal Academy of Music by train. That was her first day. What was her age at that time? You remember, it was 70. Then she auditioned. Audition means gave a short performance for the sake of selection. You must have heard that Indian Idol or Dance India Dance competition is going to start, and auditions are going to be held. What are those auditions? These are short performances given by performers for the sake of selection. Now, she auditioned for the Royal Academy of Music and scored one of the highest marks in the history of the Academy. In the history of the Academy, very few people had scored such high marks as she had scored. She gradually moved from orchestral work to solo performances. Slowly, gradually, you know the meaning. Slowly, she moved from orchestral work. Earlier, she was playing with orchestra, but now she started giving solo performances. What are solo performances? Solo performances are the performances given by single performer. Other performers may be there, but they are only there to support the lead one. So she started giving solo performances now. At the end of her 3-year course, she had captured most of the top awards. Her course at the Royal Academy of Music was of 3 years, and at the end of the course, she had captured most of the top awards given at the Academy. Now, pick out the correct option. Evelyn has never given a solo performance. True or false? Evelyn has never given a solo performance. True or false? Yes, it is false. She moved from orchestral work to solo performances at a very early age. Evelyn got admission to the Royal Academy of Music at the age of, what was her age? I told you, 16 or 17. Yes, it was 17. Now, students, read these sentences. Don't listen through your ears. pay attention to this word don't. They called her name and she didn't move. I suddenly realized she hadn't heard. These words are called contractions. A contraction is a shortened form of a word or group of words that omits certain letters or sounds. In most contractions, an apostrophe represents the missing letter. Here, this apostrophe represents the missing letter. That means D-O-N-O-T. It should be do not. Instead of writing do not, we have written don't. Contracted, shortened it. This is the short form of do not. And we have placed an apostrophe to denote a missing letter. Same is the case here. Didn't. It is did not. Hadn't. It is the short form of had not. Some contractions are, for he would or he had, we have heeth. He apostrophe D. I have can be contracted to I've. They are can be written as there. Cannot is written as can't. Do not is written as don't. I am as I'm. She is as she's. Let us as let's. Has not as hasn't. These contractions are normally or usually used while we speak this language to make it more fluent. Now, thinking about the text, here are some questions for you. How old was Evelyn when she went to the Royal Academy of Music? When was her deafness first noticed? When was it confirmed? Who helped her continue music? What did he do and say? You have to answer these questions in brief in about 30 words. Then read the remaining part of the lesson on your own and try to guess the meanings of difficult words in the text. This is your homework, the question answers and reading. Now I'm going to leave you with a verse of Evelyn Glennie. Hearing is a form of touch. Isko dobara se kar dete. Now I'm going to leave you with some words of Evelyn Glennie, what she says about hearing. Hearing is a form of touch. She calls it a form of touch. I could hear less through the ears, but more through the body. She says that she could not hear so much through her ears as through her body. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. Thank you.